guys. So I started the Huey. I've put it together. I've given it a quick undercoat with the Mr. Surfacer 1000. I really like this stuff for scale model kits. I'm sort of just trying it out with the Flames of War resin kits just to see if it see if there's any improvement in anywhere for when I go to airbrush some olive drab or green, brown violet, whatever they call the US armor anyway, color onto it. So that's it there. Now you can't really see too good. I made the tail rotor up out of a bit of plastic card. It was actually the bit of the box, the bit of the clamshell that the that this particular model come in. I basically went on the website, traced out the that shape and just made it to the appropriate size, put it on the bit of plastic, cut it out and glued it on. It looks okay. So that's it there. It's still sort of drying. The blade, this blade here is fully magnetized, so for storage, and it's gives that, you know, you can sort of spin it. So if you say this is a tree and you come down to land, you can sort of spin your blade like this so it doesn't interfere when you go to land. Alright guys, on that note, stay tuned for the next step, which will be the base coat. Cheers, eh? Okay guys, there we go. Got the base colour down. So I've gone with, let's have a look here. Brown violet for the base colour. So I've used the Mr. Surfacer. What do I think of Mr. Surfacer? It's okay, but you have to apply a very, very thin layer of the base coat before you start, and let that dry before you start getting into it and getting that base colour down nice and strong. It's an interesting paint. It's probably not the right stuff to be using, but I wanted to try it anyway. Now you can see it's quite glossy at the moment. It is touch dry, but it's still drying. Now guys, if you're doing a lot of airbrushing, use a retarder just to slow down the drying process of your paint. You will eliminate nearly all of your airbrush problems with dry tip, clogging, or anything like that if you use a retarder. If you don't use a retarder, you're going to have all the problems under the sun and you'll get very frustrated with airbrushing and you just won't be happy with it. I can put a few drops of this in and spray from one little pot, you know, 15-20 minutes worth, just, you know, and still never have a dry tip. So it is a must. So so yeah, there we go. There's the base colour. I've got the rotors here. The rotors are done in German grey, and wait for the next one, guys. Okay
guys, and here we have it all painted up, with minus the crew. We've just got to put the crew on now. At the end of this short little vid, because I'm taking it on my iPhone, there will be some photos, so let's go around and have a quick look. It's not the best of quality in the photos, but so awesome to paint. Well, thank you guys. I'll do the crew up, we'll stick the crew on, and we'll come right back. Cheers, eh?
And there we are, guys. There is the Huey, all finished. awesomely, it was awesome to paint. Thanks a lot, guys, for the suggestion. The model is fantastic. Apart from the actual dudes that you get given, their faces are pretty munted and fucked up, so it must have been just a bad mold. I used them anyway because there's no other figures I'd had. I looked around that could resemble Vietnam sort of figures, especially holding an M60, so... I've got some tropic, some Vietnam badges, I did the windows just like on the website. I just thought that looked good, so just went with that. I had another idea of painting, seeing if I could paint some of the internals and stuff, but I didn't want to go too in depth when I was getting back into it. So that's her. There will be some still photos, guys. Thanks, A, for the suggestion. Now, what to paint next, I suppose. Cheers, A.
Maybe then I'll fade.